Good morning, people, and welcome to the channel. Today we're doing a review and a cook on the Masterbuilt 1050, and we're using the L.S.S mod kit for converting it from a grill to a nice little hot plate setup. So we've got things on the go, and we've got looking for a surface temperature of possibly 300, 350. Get the old thermometer out. Oh wow, okay. We're right up towards the center is really on the hottest point, so we go to the back. We're down around 400, so depending on what I want to cook. So okay, let's get some veggies on first and get these sauteed up. So we'll put these on the right hand side. Kicked in to keep the temp up. And this is very similar to the 800 we also have. We can use that, but it's got its own dedicated hot plate, so we can still use this openly. This is a very good unit, very good for cooking, smoking. This is the first unit I bought. Very happy. Got a gravity fed charcoal system on the side of it. So we don't have to keep feeding it. PID system, which controls all our temps for us. We've got some nice ingredients there. You can see we've got some mushies up the back there and some bacon. And some nice cheddar cheese. And we've even got extra few rashers of bacon there we can cook up as well. So go back to our veggies. There we go. Simmering away nicely. Now what I'm going to be doing today is a nice little, hopefully, a nice stuffed omelette. Egg mixture over there ready to go. I've used the right hand side to keep the left hand side for the eggs. Thank you. help us. See if we can get out now. This little kit comes with the two hot plates from L.S.S. Woods, and it also comes with a shroud for the manifold underneath, which directs all your heat to the top without it going around the system too much. So it keeps it more direct to the hot plate, which is a very good feature for the two units. The 800 comes with its own. Closest part to you, because most of your heat is directed to the centre of it, you've virtually got some cooking zone. So if you want something to cook a bit slower, then you can have it closer towards the front of the unit, so that it doesn't cook too quick. Let these cook for a couple of minutes and we'll come back. Right. Oh, I've got some diced bacon on, and the bacon fat will help put some nice flavours to the veggies and whatnot that we have on. To try and keep this moving so it doesn't stick too much, although as much as I do have seasoned cooking surface, it seems to be going along quite nicely, so let's go and get our egg mixture. Okay, so now I've put some nice little seasoning through the eggs, as you can see with that. Bacon, honey bacon barbecue crunch. I think that'll go down quite well. And mix that through with the eggs. All in all, hopefully we'll have a nice little meal. We'll pop that on there. What I hopefully intend to do, I'm probably going to overstuff this because I've got miles too much here, but give a bit of a piece that we've missed. Alright. Let's get our egg mixture on. Quite nicely. I have to retrieve that bit of bacon back a bit later. Yes, we lost him. Right, well that's cooked pretty quick by the look of that. Thank you.
There's a label that goes in this one
of these. All these little things here. There might be room for some magic. Whoops, we lost him. Oh dear. A little bit too early. Still, back pain. It'll hold. Yeah. Probably shouldn't leave this for too much longer, I don't think, so I think we might have to put some of this on top. A little bit of in the right way. Stick, which unfortunately doesn't look like it's going to. Not looking good. Not looking good. Not looking good at all. No, I think we've killed it. Never mind. Alright, let's do the best we can with it. I don't think our surface was ready, so right then. Nevertheless, we will push on. Let's work a bit of magic here, so we'll sprinkle a little bit of cheese over the top. Let it work its magic and then we'll serve it up and see what it tastes like. All right, let's see how we go. Unfortunately, I don't think this will get out the way I wanted it to, but I'm sure it'll still be edible. Put him on the plate. There we go. I think we might actually go and get. Big deep dish thingy for getting enough plate without killing it. I already have. There we go. Right, so let's even plant it up. Unfortunately, not quite the way I wanted it to turn out, but I'm sure it'll still be edible. We will go and endeavour to have some breakfast, and we will catch you all next time. So if you like what you see, please subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell so you'll catch future uploads, and please do feel free to subscribe. I do like getting new subscribers, and thank you for watching.